This episode of DNews is brought to you by the U.S. Air Force. A satellite landed a probe on a comet today, but it was launched like 10 years ago. So why does it take so long to get there? Hey everybody, thanks for watching DNews. I'm Trace. The comet 67P Churyumov-Gerasimenko is heading to the inner solar system on its trip around the sun. 67P flies around the sun and then out past Jupiter every 6.45 years. It was discovered in 1969 and selected for the Rosetta mission in the early 2000s. Rosetta's plan is to learn about the structure and behavior of comets. But Rosetta was launched way back in 2004, and 67P is still out past Mars, so why launch it so early? It takes only like half a year to get to Mars. Well, because gravity. When a rocket reaches space, it had to escape Earth's gravity to get there. The escape velocity from Earth's surface is 11.2 kilometers per second, or about Mach 33. Yeah, it's really fast. Once in space, Rosetta will have to travel at least that fast to begin its massive parabolic orbit on the way to catch this comet. The thing is, even at 11.2 kilometers per second, it still needs more power. 67P is traveling at 37.5 kilometers per second. As the mass of the fuel increases here on Earth, it's exponentially more difficult to lift a rocket to that escape velocity. So, the most fuel-efficient solution to accelerate the satellite to that speed as of now is to perform gravity assist maneuvers once in space, to fling a craft around a planet and take advantage of its gravity. So you're flying toward Earth and gravity is pulling you down closer and closer to the planet. It's faster and faster, and then you zoom past it at astronomical speeds, which is great. But then the same gravity is pulling you back, right? It's pulling you back down toward Earth, like a biker going downhill and then back up a hill of the same size. The net change at the end of the day, flying past a planet, should be zero, right? But there's more to it than just the craft and the gravity of the planet. There's also the movement of the planet. It's spinning and flying around the sun. The flinging of a craft around a massive celestial body at just the right angle speeds up the craft by stealing a bit of energy from the planet. That's kind of mind-blowing, right? For example, when Voyager 2 was flung toward Saturn by Jupiter in 1979, Jupiter slowed by 10 to the negative 24th kilometers per second. That's really, really small number. But Voyager gained 10 kilometers per second, which is a huge gain for a tiny spacecraft, an imperceptible loss for Jupiter. We call it a slingshot. Rosetta left Earth in 2004 on a regular orbit until it encountered Earth again almost exactly 1 year later. Using Earth's gravity, Rosetta flung itself around Earth and headed for Mars. In early 2007, Mars gravity slapped it on again on another path toward Earth, where our gravity gave it a good smack later in that same year. Finally, after a much longer orbit and a third Earth flyby in 2009, it settled into a giant orbit, which brought us to November of 2014, when it finally caught up with 67P, the comet it had been chasing for the whole time. These gravity assists took a long time, but allowed the craft to accelerate to 55,000 kilometers per hour, using only the gravity of planets and a little bit of fuel to make course corrections and slow it down. It's not the most direct solution, but it's efficient, and it allowed it to fly past a few asteroids on the way too. Rosetta is orbiting a body with a gravitational pull several hundred thousand times weaker than here on Earth, and it's moving at about 1 meter per second relative to the asteroid, which is about the speed of a walk. In the end, Rosetta stole energy from two planets and flung itself around the sun 5 times in the last 10 years. But now, thanks to that physics and lots of math, we landed on a comet this morning for the first time ever in human history. What awesome! Stories like this make me think, damn, trying to land a spacecraft on a moving comet just seems impossible. But somehow science is making it happen. You know who else is good at achieving the impossible? The brave men and women of the United States Air Force. Whether it's overcoming poverty to become a nurse and an officer, or becoming the first female Thunderbird pilot, these airmen are doing what others once thought was impossible. So a big shout out to the US Air Force for supporting DNews. To learn more about Rosetta and its mission, click here to see that handsome devil talk about it right over there. Or you can go to the description and check out discoverynews.com. There's a link down there. They are covering the crap out of this. Really awesome stuff. Make sure you leave a comment down below and subscribe for more DNews every day of the week. Thanks for watching.